a different type of damage than broad. I think broad is slashing and brunt, blunt is piercing, or maybe it's the other way around. I'm not exactly sure. Usually I thought I told you, but I think you have to make the arrow, actually. Let's do... I think broad's the way to go. So let's buy some broad. Double-click on it. Then I'm going to click on the arrow shafts. There we go. So now we got some more. We got 100 broad arrows. I'm at 99% burden, so I'm just under 100%, which is perfect. Let's quickly go back up here. I'm going to quickly sell this and get the hell out. A dodge. Hopefully I can find a decent leveling spot. I don't even know where to go. I'm just going to run around. I want to get out of town as quickly as possible, though. This is really dangerous for me to even be here, especially being level 6. Okay, cool. Let's go. That was a decent... That's cool. So I got like a buff from that in the back of that building. I got like something called a Fletcher's Boom or something like that. It's pretty awesome. I found this. It's cool. You know, a lot of these items that you pick up in this game as well are magically imbued. So, you know, like the bow that I just looted from a monster at one point. It's a short bow. It's not my best. You know, I'd rather get a longbow. But it does a bunch of cool stuff. It has a spell called Aurora Blood Drink Yourself 2. And has damage bonus of 4, so sometimes you can get these magical weapons. And you can tell they're magical because they're kind of like highlighted. It's definitely easy to tell. But I wouldn't mind going to Arwick. I just don't know exactly where I'm going, to be honest. I do believe there's a Loc in this game. Is it Loc? /Loc? Yeah, there you go. Think about it. The reason I'm going to Arwick or trying to go to going to Arwick is just because I know that area. It's so weird, man. Being like 15 years old, literally, just like I still remember that area. I still remember to go. I know like some of the leveling spots around there. Although it's a lot harder up there, and I think actually level 6 is pretty damn low. But I still feel like I can level up pretty fast if I get to a decent spot. Yeah, gamer, man. I mean, especially, yeah, you know, $10 for a lifetime sub. Are you kidding me? I mean, if you're a fan of this game, obviously you are. You played it in the past. I mean, it just makes total sense. Absolutely, man. It's awesome. I'm very excited to actually be able to kind of start over again in this game. It's been forever, but I don't think I need it. I'm just going to drop that. What is this? Studded leather. I can wear this for sure. Bludgeon. Cool. So there's some... Oh, you can dye armor, by the way, guys. You can dye your armor down the road, which is pretty epic. Pretty sure I can wear these. What the hell? Why can't I wear these? I'm so confused. I don't know what's going on. I can't wear... Maybe I can only wear leather right now. Maybe eventually I can wear studded leather. Maybe there's something I have to... Some skill I have to get, garnish or something like that. It's been forever, but... So another thing that happens, what am I at, 95, another thing that happens, when you do die, you get something called a Vi penalty, and basically what that is all of your stats are reduced, basically, and the only way to get them back to normal is you have to kill monsters and gain experience. I mean, you can kill players, but... Yeah, so you not only lose experience, but you get a Vitae penalty. I don't exactly know how to pronounce it, but... again, the best way to get rid of that, and I think it's gone, but it does show up sometimes. I think it's up here that it might show up. You know, especially on a bad day, you know, you get killed like 10 times by a PK, you know, you're going to have a bad death penalty. You're going to have to go kill monsters for a bit, pretty much, so... So these drudges are really not too hard. These are kind of like the low-level mobs, but there's a lot of mobs in this game. I would love to find some ulthies. I just don't know how... they're probably pretty high level, so... I'm just killing as I go along here. Looks let's see. Oh, here we go. Scavenger. This guy might be too hard for me. I don't know. I'm going to give it a try, though. Oh, boy. He's coming my way. That's not good. Huh. Okay. Not as hard as I thought. I don't want to pick up too many things just because I'm already at, like, almost 100%. Once you're burdened, you start to kind of slow down a bit, so. But yeah, that's kind of like... Man, that lightning sound is so loud, I can barely hear. I don't know if that's like that in the on the stream or not, guys, but... Yeah, you know, I didn't know what was going to happen with Asheron's call. I knew there was always a cult following. I knew that, you know, the game has been alive since 2000. There's always been a player base. But, again, Turbine was cool enough to be like, yo, we're going to keep the servers. You can still have your Darktide, you know, but it's just obviously, you know, they're, you know, dropping the monthly sub. So it's a lifetime $10 sub. You get Asheron's Call and Asheron's Call 2 for $10 forever. It's amazing. It's so amazing. And I think it might be hard for maybe some players to come in for the first time in 2015 and play, but like when this game first came out, this game was amazing. Just again, the rule set, and kind of like Brent was saying as well, you know, EverQuest had a crazy rule set like that too. You know, you had the death penalty. Leather curious. Hold on a second. So I don't think I can wear studded leather, but I can wear leather right now. So let me just check this out. What do I get out of this? Okay, so there's this, there's some spells associated with this. You know, this is obviously improves a shield or armor's value by 50 points. Pretty sure I can wear this. What the fuck? Why can't I wear this? What's going on here? What the hell? What am I doing wrong here? Why can't I wear this? These magic armors? I don't know what the hell I'm doing. I must be missing. There must be a skill I'm missing here. I don't know what skill it is. Maybe my strength isn't. Maybe my strength isn't high enough. I can honestly, if I get a good leveling spot, I can just crank out levels pretty quick, and then I can really worry about my skills. But seriously, I don't know why the hell I can't wear that stuff. It doesn't make any sense. Maybe my strength. Oh, you know what? It's probably my strength. Let me take a look really quick again. Oh, Arcane Lore 51. That's why. I gotta get Arcane Lore up. I'm an idiot. Okay, let's see where we're at for Arcane Lore. Go here. Oh, 32. Jeez, I got a long ways to go. Get this shit up, dude. Go to 51. Yes, just keep going. Arcane Lore is pretty important anyways, right? Okay, let's go to missile weapons, or I need to get up as quickly as possible. This is how I shoot, helps you fire missiles, weapons such as bows, crossbows. Yeah, that's important. Okay, so now, I'm an idiot, now I can wear this. Let's try this again. What? So there's other skills that I'm missing. Let me see what else I'm missing here. Spellcraft 51, son of a bitch! Where's my spellcraft? Hold on a second, it's up here. What? All right, hold on, guys. Ugh, I'm such a noob. Spellcraft. Where's spellcraft at? Do I even have it? I don't even think it's trained. I probably should train it, guys. What? Missile defense, that's probably important to get. How many, okay, 6 credits. So another thing is, like, these are untrained skills, right? So I actually, you have to be very wary of what you train up, because you really, every time you level up, right now, obviously, it's going to be easy to level up, but once you, like, start to hit level 30, level 40, it's a little bit harder to level up, and so you have to take, you know, I think you only get one skill credit per level, so you have to be careful. This is six skill credits to train. Obviously, missile defense is important for me. Quickness and coordination, that's pretty much what I maxed out already. Where can I show you guys that? Let me, coordination 115, quickness 112. As you can see, these are three times higher than anything else here, just because as an archer, coordination and quickness are pretty key. That's kind of my goal here. So, so mana 174. Maybe I need mana 174 as well. But spellcraft, I don't understand why I can't find this. What, my mana is 10? Are you kidding me? So activation requires arcane lore 51, spellcraft 51. I should probably get my mana up a bit too. I mean, stamina is important as well, but I'm just trying to see if I can actually wear this right now. Where is... Yeah, totally, man. To be a mage in this game, you actually have to have mana stones, and you have to have herbs on you that, you know, allow you to cast. Yeah, every time you cast a spell, like, we can go, let me show you real quick, under magic. So, like, all these are just the basic spells, but, you know, when you right-click, this is what you need to actually cast it. I need, again, the stone. So, yeah, it's very, it's not simple, dude. It's complex. There you go. I need a, you know, all these right here, these are the basic components you need to cast spells in this game. And obviously, as you get to higher spell levels, you have to have different components with you. Magic defense, salvaging, run. I don't understand where... I don't even see it. Just weird. I don't even. It's so weird, man. Spellcraft. Where the hell is spellcraft? I don't see it anywhere. So obviously I can't wear this. I need to get my mana to 174 anyways. But spellcraft. I'm just trying to find spellcraft in the first place, and I don't see spellcraft. I don't see it under attributes. It should be under skills, right? But look, I don't see it anywhere. Maybe I missed it, but... Another thing as well, and this is something that I've never seen in any other game, there is an allegiance system in this game. And basically, what can happen is someone can swear allegiance to your character, and when I'm offline, that person, if they're leveling up, a little percentage of their experience that they level up actually goes to me. So if I had 100 people below me, I would be leveling up even if I'm not even playing the game. And that's a whole other detailed, in-depth part of Asheron's Call. There's a whole allegiance system where you can be a vassal to somebody else. Very, very interesting how that works. And it's been a while, so I don't even know where I look for that, but... Yeah, that's something that's also pretty viable down the road. Huh. Yeah, that's really weird. I can't seem to find spellcraft. I don't know. Maybe... Yeah. Maybe I'm missing something. Maybe my character just doesn't have it. Maybe I definitely am not a mage, so maybe I can't wear this specific leather. Curious, which sucks, because it's... I wouldn't mind wearing a leather magic. Uh-oh. Oh, boy. Oh, these guys are pretty easy, though. One shot. Cool. So I just leveled. So another magic item here. Maybe one of these items will actually allow me to do something here. Stamina potion's nice. I love how you just get decent loot from these low-level mobs. It's great. Arcane lore 46. Spellcraft 46. What the fuck? Where is spellcraft? Where the heck is spellcraft? What, am I retarded? Am I stupid, guys? Like, is spellcraft arcane lore? No, spellcraft should be its own thing, right? I don't see it anywhere. Ah, I'm such an idiot. I don't want to ask in chat because I'm going to get demolished for being such a noob. Seriously, if any of you guys are Asheron's call players, please let me know what I'm doing wrong here. Spellcraft. I know that it's here somewhere. It's so weird. There's maybe an untrained skill that I maybe need to pick up or something. Maybe it's magic item tinkering? What's this? Lets you add magical properties to weapons and armor. That's pretty cool. Missile defense. I need to get that for sure. That's huge. Especially as an archer. So three more levels I can get missile defense, which is going to be huge. So unusable skills. Alchemy, cooking. Oh, man, I can't do alchemy, huh? That sucks. Dirty fighting, life magic. Again, really weird. I don't know where spellcraft is, man. I must be a noob, because I swear it's got to be here somewhere. Anyways, looks like I get strength up a little bit here. Gonna endurance is obviously important. Coordination is huge. Quickness is huge. Uh-oh. Oh my gosh. This guy... Oh, jeez. Wow, I just died. Wow, that was like, Damn, dude, that was, harder mob than I thought. Okay. Well, let's go back there real quick. Jeez. I thought it was like in an easy zone. Maybe he just was a harder... It's like a boss mob or something like that. Really weird, though. I don't know where spellcraft is, so I can't wear these magically imbued armor sets yet. Gotta figure out how to do that, to be honest. But again, the ability to dodge projectiles in this game, especially when this game came out, it's just unbelievable. Skill-based game, FFA PvP. Is that a player? It's a mite, okay. Yeah, well, I need to get my health up for sure. I do have a penalty, death penalty as well. Let me see where that's at. There it is. Due to your recent death, you have temporarily lost 5% of your vitae, something like the life force. This means your health, stamina, mana, and skills are temporarily reduced by 5%. I've also lost experience as well. But again, you gain this back pretty quick once you kill monsters. So, as you can see, the day and night cycles are actually pretty amazing in this game. I mean, for a game that was released in 1999, or beta at least in 1999, I don't know. Pretty impressive game. I kind of wish more games followed in Asheron Call's footsteps, but, you know, a game like this is far and few between, and it's rare to see games like this. I think the only other game that kind of came close to this was a game called Darkfall, which is actually inspired by the Darktide server. Some of the devs were big Darktide players, and they were inspired to make a game called Darkfall because of that. So I don't know if I'm going to be able to find my body or not. I don't even know what the hell I'm doing, but... Okay, there's a healer. That's cool. Hey, buddy. So there's bandages. Yeah, yeah. Cool stuff. Okay. I'm still trying to figure out how I can tell an enemy's, how hard they are. I don't know, maybe, doesn't give me, you know, it doesn't have that, red or per, you know, it doesn't give you that ability. I know there's a way to tell, though. Small Shadow Child. Oh boy, that's not good. I'm out of here. These guys do a lot of damage. I totally just dodged some sort of, projectile there. Well, yeah, I guess I'm not going to worry too much about my body. I just need to kill some mobs real quick. Banditing Scalix, give it a try. couple more kills, I should get my my death penalty completely erased here. Let's see what we got. Spellcraft 49. I'm so confused, man. I don't understand why I can't find spellcraft anywhere on my guy. You know, I think you're right, man. I'm an idiot. Just Some Gamer said, so spellcraft may refer to the spell level of the item itself, not the level that you need to have. Or possibly the level of the item magic school you need to have. Dorian also linked a good wiki. I might check that wiki out in a second. Yeah, I think you're right, dude. Yet I'm still unable to use it, so I need to figure out why. Can I use this? Okay, Arcane Lore, 49. Yeah, I think maybe you're right, man. Let's give it a try. So I'll take my... You're right. You're totally right. So I can wear it. You're right. So spellcraft is... Okay, I was thinking it was like something I had to train or something, but you're right, it's not. Cool, so this crown gives me some cool magic properties. Armor level's amazing. I'll take that. It beats the hell out of this, right? 130. My armor level is like 267. Slashing protection above average. So you have all these different... electric. That's pretty decent. That's cool. And then I do have a couple spells that are associated with this. And again, everything is dyeable in this game too, which is pretty awesome. I don't have any dyes yet, but I know down the road it's always fun to dye your armor and make it cool. So, all right. Awesome. I feel like I'm slowly kind of learning the game again here. It's been forever. Oh, I made some strong coffee and it's delicious. All right, cool. We got some more magic stuff. Oh, this game is so awesome. I'm just so happy. Like, talk about nostalgia. I can't. I mean, I remember waking up at 5 a.m. before school, and I would play. I would hook. You know, because back then, I was on a modem, so I would have to tie up the phone line to be able to even play this game. And so 5 a.m, no one's on the phone, everyone's sleeping, so I had a couple hours in the morning. That's how amazing this game was when it first came out. I would literally wake up early just to play. There's not a lot of games I could say that have done that to me, where you actually want to play so bad, especially just like the level cap in this game, and you know, everyone was fighting for higher levels, and there was guild, you know, there's guild rivals, and just a lot of really cool stuff. So, and again, FFA PvP, you can kill your own, even if you're connected with a guild, if the guy that you swore allegiance to in front of you, you can kill him if you want to, you know, like you can attack anybody in this game. Not even your guild is protected. I've watched guildies fight it out before and kill each other and loot each other. And, you know, that's just, it's amazing. I wish there was a more MMOs that had rule sets like this. But, all right, let's see what we got here. Cool, this is chill, nothing crazy. I don't think it's the best, I mean, but it's good to have bracelets right now because I already have one, I guess, so I can't use it. Having expensive jewels in your inventory kind of helps you stay protected. You don't lose some of your items. But I will lose the jewels, which is fine. All right, let's see what we got here. Lore 46, okay, cool. So I do have Lore 46, so I should be able to wear this. Awesome. Very cool. And it looks like I got a decent spell there. That's okay, cool. Bludgeoning Protection 2. Reduces damage of the caster. That's awesome. That's huge. So I'll take that. Let's put this back on. So I really want to wear this leather cuirass here. Cuirass. Leather cuirass. Sorry, guys. So mana 174. I gotta get mana to 174. That's it. That's all I need. It's easy. Okay, let's do it. Yes. It's gonna take me a while to get it to 174. Damn it. It's okay. Yeah, okay. Anyways, let's continue to level. I should be able to level pretty quick. I need to find a good spot. Ooh, get away from me. Yeah, once you start to learn the basics, I would say as well, one of the cool things about Asheron's Call that's been revised, like the latest version of Asheron's Call, and this they never had this when I first started to play, but they have a whole tutorial system. When you first start into the game as a new character, you go through this big tutorial on how to, you know, equip weapons, kill monsters, just the works. And basically, that's a really good thing to have for new players, especially a game that's in depth and as detailed as Asheron's Call. It's good to have that. So there's a good tutorial at the beginning of this game that can really help new players out. But again, the big thing for me is just learning. You know, it's like I'm getting back on the training wheels again. It's like it's been so long since I played this. There's still so many things that I forget. There's shortcuts and hotkeys and just different things that I, you know, have not done it in this game for so long. I need to refigure it out. But you've got mail. Yeah, dude. Exactly. Oh boy. Oh, this is not good. I need to get out of here. So these guys are a little bit too. So I'm getting into like some harder mobs here, which is good. I really want to try to get to Arwick if I can. I just don't know exactly. I think I know where I'm running. I know Arwick is north. It's north of Holtburg. So, oh, there's a snowman. They still have the snowman in the game. These guys are crazy. Let me see. Let me attack this guy real quick. I'm pretty sure there's parts of this map that have snow as well. Oh! Didn't do a lot of damage. There we go. Okay. Wow, he's loaded. What do we have here? Got an Azurite gem. Got a carrot. Magic ice ball. Yeah, I remember we had snowball fights in this game. I'll tell you, the dev team of Asheron's Call really, like in terms of events, they're the best. They put on the best events. I don't think there's any other game that I could say, don't get me wrong, I mean, there's certain games that had pretty amazing player events, but Asheron's Call had some amazing player events that have continued on for years and years. That's really awesome as well. Their content updates were amazing as well. I remember they had the Maddie robes. Right when the Maddie robes came out, that was really hard to get. It was rare to get a Maddie robe. I was really lucky. I got one Maddie robe. I was able to stash it on one of my my mules. That was pretty amazing, though. But yeah, I don't know. I just need to figure out a good leveling spot again. I remember we really I wouldn't say exploited this game, but really for the most part, really knew how to take advantage of certain mob spawns. And you know, utilizing certain mob spawns and just grind. We would grind it up so crazy. Level like 10 to 15 levels. You know, obviously the early stages were a lot easier. Then again, once you get to a higher level, it gets a little bit harder to level up. But yeah. Oh boy. I'm gonna dodge it. You see that? You can dodge projectiles. Oh, that's not good. Yeah. I think he hit me. Oh geez, that's not good. Oh, shit! Oh, I got wrecked! Oh, man. Okay, here's the problem. These are bind stones, by the way, if you didn't know. So I'm back to Holtburg. I need to find another bind stone that's closer to Arwick. Honestly, my goal is to get to Arwick. So I gotta figure out... What the heck is this? Oh, that's cool. Kinda locks it. Yeah, I need to figure out... I'm pretty sure it's north. I'm almost positive it's north, so... I just gotta keep going this way. How am I doing on arrows? I'm doing pretty decent. Let me see here. I don't need. Man, I really want to sell those prismatic arrowheads. Why? What's bonded? Somebody's using fletching. I think you have to be a certain level in fletching to be able to use that or something. I'm not sure exactly. Didn't really have... some of my armor was off. That's stupid of me. Armor level 151. Defense... okay. Arcane Lord... missile defense 49. So that's the only way I can wear these. I don't have missile defense yet. I have to train that skill. That's the first thing I'm gonna do, anyways. That's kind of gonna be pretty important to do. I got wrecked. Hey, gamer, thanks for hanging out, buddy. All the best to you, man. No, it's good to see you again, and definitely feel free to stop by the stream, man. Yeah, it's fun to go back in Asheron's Call. I'm very happy that it's only $10 to play this game for life now. You also get Asheron's Call 2 with it. They dropped the monthly subscription in Asheron's Call now, so again, $10 gets you this game forever. I mean, are you kidding me? Especially for me, at least, you know, this is my all-time favorite game ever, out of any game I've ever played my entire life. The Darktide server is just amazing in its own right, so... it's a lot of fun. I'm just going to kill some of these low-level mobs and just get my my Vi penalty off here. Cool. So, as you can see, like, killing two monsters just totally took my death penalty right off. Oh, there's a guy. Okay. Oh, boy. Oh, boy. What am I doing? Whoa, whoa, whoa. Go, go, go. Are you serious? I don't feel like dying again, so let's just make this quick. So the wasp is almost dead. Come on. Die already. This guy shouldn't be that hard, right? Ouch. Yeah. This guy sucks. This guy sucks. Get out of here. Oh, jeez. I'm down to five stamina, so... Okay. Luckily, my guy is pretty quick. The first thing I did when I created this character is make sure that quickness was 100, and obviously coordination is quickness and coordination are really key for archers in this game. I was always an archer in Asheron's Call. It was my thing. I think that's why I love archery so much. To be honest with you, I always play. Uh oh, this is bad. This is bad. This is bad. Oh, dude, you got to be kidding me! I'm out of stamina. This is not good. I'm gonna probably die here. Fuck. You gotta be kidding me. How did that happen? There's no way I'm gonna get out of this alive. I'm screwed. I guess I can keep running. Yeah, I'm dead. That sucked. Gosh. Okay, well, let's try this again, guys. And this time I'm just going to run. I want to run to Arwick. That's the goal. Let's just run to Arwick first, and then we can bind. And then maybe start to find some mobs to fight. I'm sure there's... wow. I'm sure there's a way... maybe a portal or two that can get me closer. But I'm actually pretty sure... I think Holtberg is pretty close to Arwick. It's just south, so... I love reading general chat. You ran from a 1v2. Suck a dick, kid. You only a piece of a bear piece, LMAO. Suck a dick, kid. That's awesome. People are still salty in this game. That makes me so happy to see. It's awesome. Hey, there's let's go in here. This could be a dungeon. Oh yeah, this is definitely a dungeon. Let's read about it real quick. Dungeons can be really fun. Let's just jump in and see what it's about. Combat logging, dude. That's a good point. Although I think they fixed that for the most part. I'm pretty sure they fixed combat logging, but... There's definitely times I was chasing players in this game, they would combat log. They would jump... They would do a jump and then off a hill and then literally, boom, Alt F4'd it. It's crazy, but good times, nonetheless, good times. Okay, well let's check this out, guys. I don't know how the level how the leveling is going to be in here. We'll see how the mobs are. But yeah, the amount of awesomeness they have in this. So that's the surface. Wait a second, is there another door here? The amount of, like, dungeons they have in this game is just amazing. There's so much... Oh, boy. There we go. Here we go. Okay. Yeah. Oh, jeez. I should probably attack you here. So these guys are pretty easy, but there might be, like, a hard one at the end or something like that we can check out. Okay, got some more magic stuff. See if it's even useful. Okay, Lightning Protection, Self 2, Arcane Lore 34, so I should be able to wear those. Although I have to take my pants off. I know, don't get too excited. I'll take it. Alright. Leather leggings, put them over, right? There we go. Leather cowl, what do we have here? Flame Bane 1, that's decent. Not the best in the world. Covers head though, but I already have a crown that's pretty amazing, so I don't think I'll drop that. So I just need to get to like, oh boy, how does that even make any sense here? Drop it. My burden's 100, which is not that big of a deal, but it does make a difference. It's gonna drop this. It's gonna drop this. There we go, 98. Okay, we're good. That's right, gem. Anything special I could do with this? Mana renewal. Okay. Let's continue on, guys, in the adventure here. Asheron's Call, Darktide. Again, if you're just joining us, welcome to the party. We are playing Asheron's Call on the Darktide server. This game is officially $10 for a lifetime subscription. They've dropped the monthly subscriptions, $10 to play this for life. If you've ever played this in the past, you know how nostalgic and amazing this game is. This game is so in-depth for what it is and for what it was and for what it is, because it's still running, obviously, so... I do believe the devs, they haven't released the source code, but they, what the heck? But they are giving players the option to have their own servers down the road, which is going to be interesting to see. Maybe that gives you, gives them the ability to actually have their own rules, which is pretty awesome as well. Oh man, this is just so much fun. I can't believe we're playing this. This is amazing! Okay, what is this? What do we got here? Wield requires level 30. What the hell? Missile decreases. What is this? Oh! Get away from me, buddy. I'm just trying to... So again, these guys aren't too hard, but I bet you there's going to be a harder boss at the end. There's always a boss of some sort. Okay, what do we got here? Oh, I can probably wear this, actually. Looks like I can wear this. A Drudge Charm. I think I need that, actually. I know there's a reason to hold on to that. Sorry I'm taking so long. I'm just trying to figure this out. I can't wear this? Why can't I wear this cloak? It says I can wear it. I'm confused here. What is going on here? Why can't I wear a cloak? Okay, I don't know. I don't know why. It's not a big deal, but... Okay, still can't wear it. Whatever. We'll deal with it later. Okay. Yes, dungeons are FFA as well, Dorian. Anyone can zone in where you are. Yes, exactly. Other players can jump in here and attack me and kill me if they wanted to. Yep. We would camp dungeons, man. I remember camping dungeons. Camping the high-level dungeons were amazing. We had some amazing fights. And what's crazy is, like, you're not only fighting the players, you are also fighting the mobs. You have to balance that out. It's pretty crazy. When mobs are aggroing, it's great. Attacking players in a dungeon at the right time when they pull like a queen, like the Queen Ulti, that was also really fun as well. They freak out and they start running at. They try to run out of the dungeon and we block them and kill them and take all their stuff. It's great. All right, what do we have here? Leather gray. Okay, let's try to wear this. I'm trying to get hooked up here with decent magic armor. Yes! Awesome. Okay, so I can... wear that, I guess. Cool. All right. Uh-oh. Somebody just spawned. What do we have here? Whoa. Defense 88. Okay, let me take a look at defense real quick. Where? Melee defense, 98. Just defense? I should be able to wear that. Okay. Weird. Okay. Can't wear it for so. Oh! There we go! Yes! Yes! That's so awesome! I'm so happy. Awesome. Okay, cool. That worked. So, give or take, I guess I can't wear some of these again, but that's okay. That's a good, that's really, I got a, that's a good stuff. So, slowly but surely, I'm starting to get some decent armor. Oh, boy. Let's turn around really quick. Getting some decent armor. Nothing crazy just yet, but... Okay, so I'm not going to worry about leaving looting him right now. Let's just see what we have down here in the dungeon. Oh, boy. Oh, and there's a dude. What's up, buddy? So this is where, oh, boy, there's a couple guys here, Are we done? Whoa, they're all coming from nowhere here. Luckily, they're not too hard. Down to, I need to rest up. I know there's a way to rest up as well. I have to figure out what that is, but... Leather vest. What do we have here? Wow, that's pretty awesome, actually. Let's get this, let's loot this real quick. I was never a crossbow fan, either. Crossbows, obviously, are pretty cool, but... bows. It's 100% bows for me, at least. Okay, where... Where the hell did it go? Am I that much of a noob? Where did my vest go? Oh, it's on the ground. I was just going to say, where the heck did it go? But I must have dropped it on the ground. Pick it up. Yes! Nice! Alright, I'm starting to get decent armor. That's huge. That's huge. Okay. So, yeah, again, one of the cool things in this game, you can really exploit mobs in different ways. So, like, down here, for example, I can actually attack these guys. I have to get to the... Oh, there we go. So, you can exploit monsters this way. We do this with some of the high-level dungeons as well, so you don't have to worry about the mobs too much, but you'd have to worry about players. Okay, so before I continue to shoot, I need to rest up. Hold on a second. Oh, boy, because if they spawn, I'm screwed. I'm screwed. I only have two. Let's go back up. Shit, let's go back up here. Okay, how do I rest? How do I rest? What do I do? What do I do? How do I sit down? Hold on a second. I know there's a way to sit down, guys. Crouch, H, sit is G. Okay, G, 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 G. G. I should get my stamina up a lot quicker that way if you hit G. There we go, cool. Yeah, peace mode, obviously. The tilde key you can hit for peace. So right now we're in peace mode, which basically I'm not fighting. Then I hit the tilde key. I'm ready to fight people. So good stuff. And again, like, you know, if I were to switch to... Oops, sorry. Like a wand, for example. Hold on, I have a wand in here somewhere. Where is it? Oh, did I sell the wand? Anyways, a magic, you know, a different type of combat. Different type of combat bar comes up when that happens, so. I don't need these anymore. I don't need these anymore. I don't know why I can't wear this. It says wear it. It's not letting me. I don't get it. That's weird. Anyways, we are continuing on, guys. This is great. Nostalgia to the max. And Asheron's called Darktide. I'm telling you guys. Alright, so... Let's kill these guys real quick. Ha! Ding. Uh-oh. Ooh. Wow, that hurt. That really hurt. Oh, boy. This is bad. This is bad. Whoa, they're all coming at once here. I don't feel like dying. I don't feel like dying. Come on. Come on. Come on. Kill this guy quickly. Oh, you gotta be kidding me. You gotta be kidding me. Dude, you gotta be kidding me. Okay, wow. Okay, okay. Sit. Hurry up and sit really quick. So they spawn pretty quick, actually. Restock some arrows soon. Let's see what we have. What are we at? 50. I have 50. I'm good for a bit, but thank you for looking out. See what these guys have loot-wise. So we're back. You can heal pretty quick again if you're not fighting. Silver chain. I can't use chainmail. It's either leather or studded leather for me, I think. Quickly, though. I want to get... I don't want to stay here for too long because I'm going to get a huge spawn of them again. Let's just bounce. Let's go down here. Oh. Yeah, this is one of the few games, for me at least... Being able to craft elemental arrows, like fire arrows, acid arrows, lightning arrows, I don't know. I love that. I think that is just the coolest. And then again, just the whole run system in this game. The fact that you can literally skill up your run to the point where you could be one of the fastest players in the game. Nobody can catch you. I mean, I don't know any other game that has that ability. And like actually running, just running in this game anyways, you run so fast, especially... if you have a character that's like skilled up for that. So I love that. I love running fast in this game. It's so cool. You're always on sprint. Some pretty cool. There's a frost war axe. That's pretty badass, actually. Again, I'm not a warrior in this game. I'm not doing melee. Although melee combat, if you skill up just for that, you can be really deadly. There's a stamina potion, I guess. I have a couple stamina potions already, but. Yeah, this is one of those games, you really can't be a well-rounded character. You should probably focus on one or two things. Like, I can be melee, magic and archery if I wanted to, but then you're going to sacrifice some of those skill points. So, you know, some of the best players are like, you know, 90% archery, 10% you know, melee, or 90% archery, 10% magic, or 80-20. You know, it just depends, man. It really just depends. This is a really good place to level for me, actually. I'm just getting non-stop kills. I should actually... I'm just going to grind this out for a minute here. These guys are pretty easy to kill as well. I got to be careful though. My stamina is down to 10. This is where they're spawning. I want to go continue to go down though. Studded leather girth? Oh, get those boots. Get those boots. I don't care if I'm going to be burdened. See what we got. Oh, there's so many. Dude, there's so many items in this game. It's crazy. I love this game. I love this game. I wish there was like an Asheron's Call 3 that wasn't like Asheron's Call 2, but it was like this, but with updated graphics. You know? Oh, that'd be so awesome. I'm a dreamer, though. Okay. So, let's continue on here. Hold on a second. Let me close the door and sit down for a second. Close the door. Take a seat. Let's see what we got. Okay. Okay, so that's decent. So what do we have here? It's kind of the same thing, right? It's the same exact thing. This is even better though, so I don't need that. Shit, what happened? Why can't I wear this leather vest? There we go, okay. Can I wear these boots though, is the question. Defense 91. Actually, I think I might be able to wear these boots. Yes! I got studded leather boots. Ooh, I'm starting to look sexy, guys. My character's starting to look sexy. Hey, Jeets, what's up? Welcome to the party. I never, ever played on any other server but Darktide. Darktide, for me, was the server to play on. I think I might have played on Frostfell for a little bit, just for fun, like briefly. But 99% of my gaming experience in Asheron's Call was on the Darktide server because... of the free-for-all PvP. It was all about PvP for me. Oh, Oh boy. We're starting to get some really good armor though, guys. I'm digging this. This is awesome. I mean, for my level at least, right? Oh boy. Oh boy. We got a lot of guys here. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Don't mess around. Don't mess around. Come on, dude. Come on. They're not hitting me hard, but I'm getting low on stamina. That's dangerous. There we go. Okay, okay, okay. Okay, sit down real quick. Sit down. It's not the end of the world if I die or anything. I'm doing actually doing really good. This is a good call to go into this dungeon. I'm already level 9, almost about to hit level 10. It's good. Good stuff. Okay, we're back. Let me take a sip of my amazing coffee. Oh, it's so good and it's so strong. Oh, it's delicious. All right. Oh boy. I think it's backspace to target the nearest enemy, I think. Oh, I found their bedroom. A lot of bunks here for the drudges. I didn't know drudges sleep in bunk beds. It's interesting. Foul creatures sleeping in bunk beds. It doesn't make any sense. All right, we're getting to the harder part of the dungeon. Guarantee it. So this is the cool thing about Asheron's Call as well. What I can do is I can bump up my accuracy here, all the way to the top. I probably get a good shot on this guy as well. Now high, medium, low, this really depends on your enemy. Sometimes, you know, you can miss if you use the wrong one. I'm gonna go high though for this. High can get a nice headshot, and there's a headshot, nice. So before he can even turn around, I killed him. Again, let's exploit this as well. I wouldn't even call this exploiting. I mean, obviously the devs know that you can attack monsters by being above them. So a lot of people do utilize this mechanic. Rather than getting attacked, you're able to kind of, you know, do this. Now the Ulthi dungeon is the best for this. That was like, talking about nostalgia, going into killing the Ulthi Queen, which is like, they drop some of the best loot in the game. I mean, from when I played, I'm sure there's way better dungeons now, but you know, back then, the Ulthi dungeons were amazing. Ulthis are like these weird alien creatures. They kind of remind me of like Alien, actually. Oh, here's a lever. Here's a lever. Oh, okay, that's weird. I thought that was a lever. Handbell. What is this? Okay, so this could be a quest item or something like that. We're going to continue on here. Should be a couple fights down here. Again, nothing crazy right now. Really just trying to just kind of level up. Yeah, here we go. There's a harder guy right there. Let's kill the small guy first. Go for the hard guy here. Yeah. Anything decent loot-wise? Nothing crazy. Let's quickly sit. I need to get, you know what? The first thing I need to do right now, let's just pump up my stamina. Holy crap, my stamina is so low. Are you kidding me? Level that up. Get the mana up a little bit too. Health. Obviously, coordination and quickness are important to me, but endurance is important. Endurance is to get my health up as well. Strength. I'll go to 51 strength. We don't need a lot of strength right now. It's really going to be quickness and coordination for me. I don't need willpower. I don't need focus. That's for mages. Obviously, health is important, guys. Stamina is super, super important. mana is important for the magic vests and all that stuff, for the magic armor. I don't care about melee. Melee defense is always good. Missile weapons is huge. That's crucial. Fletching is crucial down the road. Again, my goal is to be able to craft, you know, elemental arrows. That's what I'm going for here. So, cool. We're about to hit level 10 as well, which is going to be nice. Well, that helped. I need to, again, I'll be happy when my stamina is like at 100. Next couple levels, we'll really just kind of focus on health, mana, and stamina. And then we'll do, obviously, skills. In the teens, we'll start to get the skills up. But I think the core skills are important. No. So it's backspace. I kind of want to change it to tab. To be honest. Right now, tab is chat. I would rather use tab to search for the nearest target rather than having to go and hit backspace. I would rather have my left hand do that. Let's switch that in a second, actually. Just kill this guy real quick. Oh my gosh, what's going on? Hello? There we go. Okay. Switch this really quick. Okay. Oh, jeez, I'm only down to, wow, 5 arrows. That went really quick. Let's switch them up. Okay. Quickly, configure keyboard. It's not combat. It's going to be... Is it UI? Let me see what we have here. There we go. So what if we use backspace instead? To select closest compass item. Okay, so we've got to find where that is. Select closest compass item. There we go. Tab. Now, yes, that's so much better. Now I can actually use tab. So rather than taking my hand off the mouse, I got, okay. Key bindings are huge. Obviously, I have a lot more key bindings to do here, but it's important to make your gaming experience a little bit more easy. Uh-oh. Ding! You'll notice as well, you also gain skills just by using, like, just by shooting the bow, I'm gaining skills. There's different skills that you gain just by using, obviously, different things. So that's always good. What is this? Nah, not as good as my crown. My crown is pretty epic right now. Gonna hold on to it. Ooh, what's this? Wool cloth gloves, let's check it out. Whirling blade streak. I don't think I need that. We'll take a health potion. Couldn't hurt, right? Ooh, yes, yes, yes. Magic studded leather leggings. We'll take it. And quickly take this quest item, right? Is this a quest item, right? Antique goblet? Who knows? I don't even know what I'm doing. I just know that I'm grinding up here. We're leveling up decent. I think that's the dungeon for the most part. Let's quickly take a look at what we have. Okay. Oh, yeah. These are good. These are good. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Defense 50. Missile defense 50. Okay. Compared to what I have now, which is crap leggings, right? I don't even have leggings on. Dude. What? Why can't I wear these? Hold on a second. Why can't I wear these? What? Hey, hold on. Why can't I wear these? Armor level 148. That doesn't matter. 27 Arcane lore, I have that. Missile defense, 50. Fuck. Excuse my language. I don't think I had missile defense yet. No, it's 56. Oh, it's untrained. Damn it. Oh, I gotta get that up. One more level. One more level I can get missile defense trained, and then I can actually wear these. Okay, so that makes sense. Oh boy. Okay, they're spawning. What is this anyways? Cool. Just, again, magic armor is always the best. Beats non-magic armor. Obviously. I don't need this. I don't need that. What's this? Wow. Fire protection itself 3 is pretty good. But it's not going to beat this. Which is... I like rather have that. That's for at this stage of the game, that's probably better. And Silver Bracelet, what do we have? Wow. Tinkering expertise. I don't know how important tinkering expertise is, but again, it's good to have gems and like expensive oh boy, stuff on you, just because if you do die, you'll drop those instead of your good stuff. Okay, wow. What's going on? Nice. One hit shot, one hit kill. Nice. Dude, so much amazing loot in this game. It's crazy. Bronze flaming claw. That's so cool. Leather helm. What do we got with the leather helm here? I love this game. I can't wait till I can actually start to PvP, but it's going to take me a while, to be honest. It will happen, though. I guarantee it. You'll look good in that suit. I guarantee it. Covers head. Okay. Impenetrability 2. Yeah, it's not going to be as good as my crown. My crown is badass. Look how awesome my crown is. You can tell the value as well, 4,000. So here's the thing. This value is 4,000. I just got to make sure that I have stuff in my inventory that is more expensive than this crown, because if I die, I will lose my most expensive items to a player. Yeah, dude, look at that. Look at this is what my crown casts. Lightning Bane. It's decent. There's multiple stuff, though, and it does have a lot of protections against fire, cold, acid. So it's nice to have armor that really protects against this stuff, because you never know what you're, what you're going to face, what you're going to be up against, especially some of these players that are rocking, lightning damage, lightning melee, fire, swords, The elemental weapons in this game are amazing, and it's really cool to see. Not a lot of games. I don't really know a lot of games that actually are as in-depth. I mean, don't get me wrong. Graphically, what the heck? Oh, okay, that's not too bad. I mean, obviously this game was made in, 1999, 2000. The graphics aren't like amazing, but the features in this game are what make this game so amazing. And the gameplay is just awesome. Wow, $2,000 shoes? Holy crap! Let's pick those up real quick. I just don't know if that's going to be as good as my boots, though. My boots are pretty awesome. So my boots... Oops. Oh, geez, my boots are $11,000. Wow, that's insane. I will keep them. I will hold on to those. Leather helm, 4,000. I don't know if that's even worth having. I'm going to drop both these. I need to make sure that my burden... I'm overburdened just a little bit here. Anti-gob. Anything worth... What's the point of this? Nothing special. So let's drop that, please. I cannot drop that. I cannot drop it. Why can't I? You telling me I'm stuck with this goblet forever? What? Okay, that's really weird. I don't know what to say. Well, we leveled up like 3 levels already, so that's cool. Maybe it's time to get out of here now. I think it was a good run. For sure, it was a good run. Let's try to make our way to Arwick. I don't think I can wear chainmail, so there's no point in holding on to that. I think this is the way home. Whoa, there's a dude. I think this is the way home. Leather girth, what do we got? Piercing Bane, that's good. compared to the girth I have now, what do we have? Armor level 225, what do we have here? No. No thanks. Oh boy. Okay. Leave me alone, guys, please. Leave me alone. Okay. Where do I go to get out of this place? I do not know. I'm lost. This happens a lot. Oh, jeez. Not a good start. Not a good... There's too many. This is where he... Oh, boy. Not good. Leave me alone. I think it's this way? Nope. It's not this way. Oh, jeez. Oh, boy. Let's just fight these guys really quick here. There is no roadmap for the dungeons. You really have to use your memory to figure out where you came in and came out, so. Oh boy. Why is tab not working? That's not good. Okay, I need to do something really quick. No. Okay, select self. Not select closest company. How about select closest monster? There we go. Select closest monster. Tab. Yes. Thank you. That's more like it. Okay. I feel better. Okay. Guys, I don't know where the hell I have to go here. Maybe I'm in the wrong neighborhood. Oh, here we go. Maybe this is the way to Grandma's house? Is this the way to Grandma? Yes! Finally. Okay. Oh, jeez. I don't know the level cap. I just know that you can... I don't even know if there is a level cap, but I know there's, like, very high-level people in this game. Like, level 200 or something. I think you can actually just continue on leveling. I don't know... Yeah, I don't know. That's a really good question. Is there a level cap in Asheron's Call? I don't think so. Okay, gotta figure out... Let's get out of here, guys. Oh, jeez. Okay, so this is not the right place. Wow, they're everywhere. Okay. Um, 146. What do we have here? 148. A little bit better. What is it though? I gotta get missile defense next time I level up. That's what I need to do. Dude, where do I go to get out of here? I'm so confused. Every single dungeon is like this. It's always like a maze. It's gonna take a minute here. Awesome. It's really good to know. So yeah. Tenebrous says level 275 is when XP stops coming in. Yeah. And basically, he says you'll have more than enough XP to level to max everything up. Okay, we gotta figure out... I've been here already. I don't think this is the right way. right? No, this is like, this is the beginning stages, right? I swear. Oh yeah, we have to go through here, I think. Telling you, it's a maze, that's not gonna take us anywhere. Oh boy. Oh jeez. Oh jeez. Oh goodness gracious. Oh boy. I could always just die. I mean, that's worst case scenario, but I'm not gonna give up. We'll get this right here. Oh wow. So we have a super pro Asheron's Call player here, which is really good to know because I haven't played this game in 15 years. Teniverse says there is an alternate form of XP called Luminance that you can use on other types of advancement. What? When did they add that, dude? That's insane. All I want to know is, do they still have Maddie robes? I want a Maddie robe, and I want an Ulthi helm. I want a green Ulthi helm. Now, I will be the happiest camper in the world. And elemental arrows, and then I'm happy. I'm curious as to what guilds are in this game as well. A lot of interesting guilds were in this game when I left. But, oh boy. Well, I'm leveling up. I'm definitely doing a good grind here, guys. We just need to figure out how the hell to get out of here. Okay, I'm out of stamina. This is bad. Let's quickly sit down here. Sit down. Let me take a sip of my amazing Pete's Coffee. Pete's Coffee, guys. Pete's Coffee is sponsoring this live stream. Go to Pete's Coffee, get yourself a good cup of Joe. It's amazing. Oh, so good. All right. Oh, Maddie robes are still around. That is like the best news I've heard. That's the best news I've heard all day. Maddie robes are still around, guys. Maddie robes are awesome. I'm guessing they're rare, though. Hey, dude, I need to figure out how to get out of here. Yeah, Tenebris, my goal right now, buddy, is to run to Arwick. I'm only level 9, so I don't know what I'm going to do, but Arwick was my spot when I played this game back in the days. And I know, actually, crazy enough, I know that there's some leveling spots around there that I might be able to capitalize on, as well as I wonder if there's that portal system. There's a portal system, like, maybe I'm 30 seconds to a minute away from Arwick, and I don't know if it's still there, where basically you can take, like, there's like 10 portals in this little area. It's like underground or something like that. Or you go inside, and basically you can, it's kind of like a subsystem where you can really portal all around the world. I don't know if they still have that, but that's one of the reasons we capitalize on Arwick, because Arwick gave us the ability to have a home base, but also travel quickly and start to do PvP runs and stuff back in the day. So, again, it's fun to play Lone Wolf, but it's also really fun to play this game with a group of guildies and buddies. You know, that really makes it fun. But again, guys, $10 for a lifetime subscription to Asheron's Call. Are you kidding me? It's amazing. There's no more monthly sub. You can play this game for $10, and you can also play Asheron's Call too. Are you kidding me? What the hell are you doing? Why are you watching this stream? Go ahead and spend $10 and buy this game. This game is awesome. Sorry, just very, very nostalgic. This is like one of my all-time favorite games ever in the history of the world. Asheron's Call Darktide, guys. Amazing. Awesome. Tenebris, that's really cool. Tenebris says, I took several years off, but started again last year, so I had a ton of new things to learn. Yeah, I mean, that's where I'm at as well. It's been forever. There's obviously been so many updates to this game. There's a lot of new stuff in the game as well, so I'm just excited to jump back in. And again, really excited just to actually play without having to worry about, you know, paying a monthly sub. To actually play this game forever without worrying about paying money is pretty cool. I mean, don't get me wrong, this game definitely deserves monthly subs. I mean, my opinion, this game is far and few between, but the fact that they just really gave, gave players just that chance now, it's like, all right, we're going to drop the monthly sub, we're going to keep the servers, it's $10 to play this game, and if you want to play it, go for it. You know, it's awesome. Very, very cool. Okay, what do we have here? Armor level 167. Dude, I think my crown is pretty amazing. I'm just going to hold on to that. What? Hold on a second. I'm going to try something here. Let me just try something. Armor level 187. don't think it's as good. I don't think it's as good. I like the color of it, but I just don't think it's as good. Because the spells that I have, yeah, 2's it, way better armor, but the spells I have here, yeah, I gotta keep that. So let's drop this. There's so many magic items in this game, it just makes me excited. Very exciting. I'm stuck. I'm lost. I don't have Siri. I don't have GPS. There's no GPS in this game. I guess there's LOC, but I don't think you can. You do LOC in a dungeon? I guess you can. Huh. Really don't know where I am. I don't think that's going to take me anywhere. I might just, I don't want to die. That's stupid, but I know there's a way out of here eventually. That's fun. Sometimes that's a thing, too. You can really train the monsters to fall down the cracks. And that's one thing we would do. We'd, we would train all these Ulthi, and then you'd have, like, literally 20 Ulthi chasing you, and then you run to a pit like this, and then you have to time it just right, and you jump over the pit, and all the Ulthi will fall in the pit, and then you just literally camp and get a lot of experience and level up power level, basically, is what we would call it. That was fun, man. I love how they really are cool with that. It's not like, technically it was kind of exploiting, but not really. I mean, that was part of the game mechanics, It's not like you were hacking or anything like that. It was literally just taking advantage of a game mechanic that the dev team have pretty much left in. It's pretty sweet. Okay, I think I know where we're at, actually. So we want to go up here. Okay, I know where we're at now. Okay, so we want to go up here, I think. Cool, we're about to get out of here, guys. Yes! Yes, I think I know where we're at now. Ding, 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 ding. All right, let me see. Tenebris is like a pro here. Tenebris, your name sounds very familiar to me, dude. I swear I've fought you before. Okay. Da-da-da-da. So Tenebris says, they kind of tweaked monster distribution several years ago. Towns like Arwick have harder creatures outside of them now. Holt, which is where I'm at. Sashi, Yanchi are the main ones for lower levels. Okay, but if you go into any town, look for the portal to town network. That's where all the town portals are now. Okay, they're not, okay. That's where all the town, can get to any town from there. Oh, good to know. So they did change that up a little bit. I remember Arwick had this awesome portal system, and some of the other towns didn't have that, so that's why we kind of capitalized on Arwick, but it's good to know. Gepsu's in the house! Gepsu, welcome to the party! We are playing Asheron's Call today on the Darktide server. It's been fun so far. I've actually leveled the hell up. Let me do something really quick here. We're going to go and get missile defense. I needed this, and we are going to train it. Wait! I need one more. Skill credits, damn it. I need one. I need to get to level 12 before I can get missile defense up. But once we get missile defense, I'll be happy. Damn it, I thought I had that already. Okay, there's got to be a way out of this dungeon, guys, and I think it's here. It's one of these doors. It might be this door, actually. Uh-oh. He's like, this is my house, bitch! You came to the wrong house! What the hell? Okay, there we go. It's got to be here. Yes! We've made it without dying! Awesome. Oh, yeah, this is a good time for me to take a quick break. I'm just going to get some water. I'm just going to get some water really quick. I'm going to just camp right here. I'll be right back, guys. Hold tight. I'll be right back. Okay, we're back. Sorry about that, guys. Oh, crap. I forgot. Hold on. I forgot my water. One second. Okay, guys, well, I'm surprised I'm still alive. That's awesome. Good stuff. Let me take a look at the chat really quick. Dorian had a question. Dorian said, how hard is it to be a caster? It's not too hard to be a caster, man. It's just you're going to have the the components. Just like as an archer, you need the components. You need arrows. So you have to craft arrows. You easily can collect components to be a caster. Casters are, man, once you're a good a level, casters can be really dangerous. So... But again, Tenebris probably has a lot more knowledge on that front as well. Yeah, exactly. Mana management can be a pain to start. Tenebris says, you want to specialize in something like war magic or void magic. Train life, mana conversion, and eventually get item and creature magic as well. Depending on the server, there might be bots set up that can provide high-level buffs to make leveling up easier. You can also take good summoning. The pets are really good as well. But if you go mage, make sure to start with 100 focus and self to maximize your casting skills. And that's really crucial. For example, for me, as an archer, 100 coordination and 100 quickness is pretty pretty important on the archer front. And again, for as a caster, as a mage, like he said, 100 focus and 100 self is going to help to maximize your damage and your spells. And then... so that's why, again, I don't really, there's no point in touching this, is because I am not a mage. I'm going archery, so this is going to be for me. dude, once you get to that point as a caster, it can be really amazing. You can do a lot of damage to people, so. Debuffing an enemy and then owning them up with a fireball, I do remember that. There's some really cool debuff spells in this game as well, so. Cool, we're doing pretty good, guys. Let me take a look where I'm at here. Let me take a look, my character. Oops. What am I doing here? Here we go. Character, sorry. Character, Okay, so level 11. Cool. And we got a ways to go, though. This is a really good dungeon run. I think we hit, like, 3 levels on this run, so that's pretty awesome. Sorry, just a business. I have a business text here. Sorry, guys. Give me 1 second. Okay, let's do this. Gepsu says, is this third-person RuneScape? Dude, this is RuneScape times a million, buddy. It's called Asheron's Call. Get with the program! RuneScape has nothing on this game. Sorry. Sorry to all the RuneScape fans out there. Yeah, RuneScape has nothing on this game, dude. This is the best game of all time. On the best server of all time, Darktide. You cannot beat this game. You cannot beat it! Alright. Damn, down to 19 arrows, huh? That's not good. I'm gonna have to craft some more. Do I have any more? Oh boy, I'm gonna have to get some more arrows here, guys. I am low. Well, we're going to have to hit another town really quick. I don't really want to go back to Holtberg, to be honest, but I guess I guess there's no point in going to Arwick then if there's going to be high-level mobs. I mean, this is a pretty decent area for me just to kind of hang out and level up, but oh, don't get me wrong, RuneScape's great, dude, but yeah, this is on another level. So yeah, we'll do this, we'll keep going for another like half an hour to an hour here and see how far we can get. I gotta get going in a little bit though. Got some errands to do. Really fun to be back in Asheron's Call though, and again, we're gonna continue to play this game and level up. Oh my gosh, what the heck is this? Grand Casino Chest. Probably need a key for that or something. Yeah, it's locked. That's pretty cool. I love how fast you can run in this game. Obviously, you have to get your run speed up, but it's just awesome. Oh, wow, I remember this. I remember this area. There's another place called the Drudge Hideout. Holy crap, I know exactly where we are, actually. I killed a lot of people on this road. This is Holtberg. How did we get back to Holtberg so quick? I must have, like, ran in a circle or something like that. We are back in Holtberg, so... Cool, at least I can get some arrows. Gotta be careful, though. There's probably gonna be some PKs around here. I might end up dying, but it's cool. Oh, there's a guy that just poured it in here. He's probably a way higher level than me. Let's see what this guy is, huh? Let's see what this guy's about here. Here's a player. He probably is protected, though, for a minute. Ooh, he's red, he's red. Ooh, I'm not even going to mess with the guy. He's a PK. He's a PK. I love PKs, I'm just not... I'm not there yet. I am such a low level, it's ridiculous. I'll get one shot pretty much by anybody. So... Okay, so quickly, let's do this. I need to get arrow shafts. Go down to fletching. Quickly. Double click. Is there anything we can sell real quick? I want to hold on to those. I don't need this. Can I sell that? Nice. Anything of value? I thought I had some value stuff here. Why can't I sell that? Silver bracelet. Okay, awkward. It's weird. Okay. Can I sell that? Nope. Oh, I can sell that cape, though. I really want to try to use, eventually wear this. I need mana. I need 174 mana to be able to even wear it, so it's going to take me a minute. Okay, so I'm at 100% burden. Okay. Let's quickly go into let's go to here. Yes, old school indeed. Only certain vendors take certain items, and only certain vendors sell certain items as well. Okay, let's get fletching items, right? Let's go ahead and do broadhead. I think broadhead is the way to go, right? We also have blunt, which does piercing damage. There's one that does slashing damage. I think broadhead does the slashing, and then I think blunt does piercing. I guess I'll take blunt as well. So we have two just in case. Cool. You know what? Let's grab, I don't care if I'm burdened or not. Let's just grab one more shaft of arrows. And then we can get, we can have a combination. We can have blunt, and we can have some broadhead as well. Okay, sorry, yeah, Tenebris is right. Blunt is bludgeon. Blunt is bludgeon, and then broadhead, I think, is piercing or slashing. This is dangerous, though. This is like I've died here like 10 times just trying to buy the shit. So, okay, cool. I would love to find a new bow as well. That's like my bow's fine, but I need to get a new bow. I want to get a longbow, hopefully, at some point. Look at the clouds. This game is really beautiful when it first came out. I played this game on a... I think I had Windows 3.1. No. I had Windows... Was it Windows 95? I think it was... No, sorry, not Windows 3.1. Windows 98. Something like that. Old school. Old school, to say the least. I was definitely proud of my 56K modem, though. That was... Playing this game on a modem was pretty cool. It actually wasn't too bad, to be honest. Let's go ahead and make some more arrow shafts. There we go. Cool. So 113, a little bit of a burden, but not too bad. As I use arrows, they're going to go down anyways. So I guess I just got to figure out where I should go now. I don't know exactly if there's any good spots to go. The dungeon was nice. I don't want to go back there, though. I want to maybe find something else. I mean, you know, oh boy, killing mobs in the open is not that big of a deal either. What do we got here? Okay, compared to what I have now, let's see here, leather greaves. Arcane Lore 93? Okay. Let's quickly see what we had here. Six. Ah, jeez. What the hell? What am I doing wrong here? What am I doing wrong here? Why can't I wear this? Why can't I wear this? Oh, jeez. What else am I missing here? Oh, crap. Mana 331. Son of a bitch. Damn it. It's okay. It's good to get Arcane Lore up for me anyways, just because I really want to get these magical, you know, it's magical armor. Magical armor is pretty awesome. I really need to focus the rest of my skills, though, on, like I was saying, like, endurance, health. Oh, boy. I got a guy behind me here. And then, you know, quickness and coordination is going to be key as well. Got it. Okay, sorry. Yeah, you're right. So the mana is how much is stored. So I wonder why I can't. I wonder why I can't use this then. Activation requires Arcane Lore 93. I have Arcane Lore 93. So why can't I use it? I'm confused. It's leather. I mean, it's should be able to use it. I'm still figuring out why I can't wear certain things, since some things that covers lower legs. Okay. Oh, there we go. Sorry, guys. I'm an idiot. That's why. It was covered by my boots. That would make sense. Yeah, that makes sense. Okay, cool. Okay. I'm a noob. I am a noob indeed here. Let's give this guy a shot here. Kind of need to figure out where I'm going. I think I'm going to head north, just for fun anyways, at least. Feather Beans is in the house. Yo, buddy, welcome to the party. Feather Beans, I'm sorry to hear that, dude. That is definitely on your end. That's going to be a connection issue on your end, man. Maybe try to restart, or maybe reset your router. Twitch can be a bitch sometimes. The stream is pretty smooth on my end. I don't have any issues. I do have it going on a laptop here. Anyone else watching the stream, let me know if it is choppy or if you're buffering a lot. I don't think that should be... my bitrate's set to pretty low. My bitrate is set so low that it's just like... I think it's the minimum, or the minimum settings for Twitch. I think it's like 3,500 for the bitrate, which sucks because I have a really good upload... speed, and I wish I can give you guys better quality. I'm not a partner with Twitch yet, so I can't do that. But again, yeah, apologies about that, and hopefully it works if you just maybe restart your computer or maybe reset your router or something like that. Okay, let me switch my arrows here. Oh boy, oh boy, I need to get out of here. Oh, get out of here. Go, 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 go. I forgot they like to bring the party with them. They don't fight alone. This is not good. I would love to go to Arwick, though. I don't care if I'm only level 11. It'd be fun to hit Arwick and bind there and just kind of go from there. I mean, I remember... When I first started playing Darktide, I think I went to Arwick when I was like level 5. But obviously, like Tenebris was saying as well, they kind of changed the spawn, so a lot harder mobs do spawn up there now, so it might be more viable for me just to level up here and then eventually hit Arwick maybe at level 20 or something like that. But yeah, sorry Feather Beans, that sucks, dude. I'm sorry to hear that. Hopefully it smooths out or something like that. Alright, let me just take a seat. Oh boy, is he chasing me still? Okay, what the heck. I love this game. Talk about nostalgia. It's good to be back. There's so much to this game. I mean, there's the lore, there's so much to this game. Skills, features, abilities, and obviously FFA PvP. That's the reason why we're here in the first place. Free-for-all PvP, baby. I have a long ways to go before I even consider doing that, though. Next level, I might just get health and stamina, and mana, just pump these up a bit as well. Endurance is going to give me health, just like health. I can always pump up endurance too. Level 15, is it worth even fighting that guy? I guess I can give it a try. See what happens. This might be a really dumb decision, but... Can I kill him? Yes! Nice! Not too shabby, actually. Killing a level 15. Ooh, we have a leather-studded shirt here as well. Let me see what we got. Arcane Lore 103. Lightning Bane. Yes, this is nice. Although my Arcane Lore is not that high yet. Oh, my Arcane Lore. What is my Arcane Lore? 93 or something like that? 93. So next level. Next level I can maybe... I just don't know if I even want to pick that up right now just because I'm already burdened here. But can I drop something? Anything I can drop? Why can't I drop these? I don't get it. I can't drop these goblets either. I don't get why. Huh. Cannot be dropped. That's weird. My life will be complete when I can start crafting elemental arrows. That's going to be when it's going to get fun. I need to get oils for that, though. Oh, man, look at that. Jumping Mastery Self, Flame Bane. Wow, holy crap, this is actually really good. Arcane Lore 185, though, I'm not even close to that. That's amazing, though. Leather shoes that have those magical properties, that's pretty good. That is true indeed, Tenebris. There's always a portal network. I can go back to Holt if I need to. That's a good point. This game is just rich. It's rich in content. It is indeed. So again, guys, if you're just tuning in, there's no longer a subscription for this game. This is an MMO. There's no longer a subscription. It's $10 for life, basically. And you can also play Asheron's Call 2. You get both games. $10 for life. Pretty awesome. It's something I couldn't pass up. Especially being one of my favorite games. Holy crap! Oh boy, this is not good. I could die in like one hit here. I'm out of here. Go. Oh my gosh, that guy runs so fast. What the hell? That is crazy. Go. I think I'm in the wrong neighborhood, to be honest. We have some high-level mobs behind. Oh, one hit dead. Damn it. Jeets, that's a good question. Hell yeah, I'm going to be streaming this more, dude. Are you kidding me? Dude, I got this game for $10. There's no monthly sub. I started a new character. I am going to be streaming this a lot more. Absolutely. I'm level 11, so I got a long ways to go. This is something. When this game first came out, there was no fraps, there was no live streaming whatsoever. There were some amazing moments in this game that I could never ever capture. Some amazing fights, PvP battles, guild versus guild. Going into towns, surrounding the town with archers with elemental arrows and taking over a town. I mean, this game is amazing, man. And again, one of the first games that I played that really, first of all, had PvP, not only PvP, but lootable PvP. And again, one of the first games that really had the ability to, in terms of the physics engine, to dodge projectiles. You can actually dodge, projectiles in this game, which means that, well, you know, there's the skill-based element that came into play. A good player could actually beat multiple other players based on how they play the game. I mean, this is a very special game to me. It's dear to my heart, and Darktide is definitely going to be the server I'm going to be playing on. And yes, we're going to be streaming more of this, man, for sure. Absolutely, hands down. And there's a lot of new stuff as well that they've added to this game that I have not seen yet. So it's going to be cool to kind of jump back in it. So yeah, more streams for sure, buddy. Absolutely. Yeah, I played the beta as well back in 99, and then when it came out, I played for a good year or so. I actually sold my account on eBay for like around, like, I think 800 or 900 bucks. I bought all of my snowboard gear with it too, so it was pretty awesome. But I actually kicked myself because I really, you know, I probably should have held onto my account, but I didn't. Without a doubt, the best gaming experience I've had in any game was on the Darktide server. It's hard to explain unless you played it when it came out. I think, I had a lot of friends that were playing EQ. EQ kind of came out, I think, right before this. If EQ didn't come out, I think this game would be a lot bigger than it. I mean, don't get me wrong, this game is still pretty big, and obviously it lasted this long. There's definitely, you know, some special qualities. But this server is not for everybody. The rule set on this server is not for everybody. Full loot, FFA, PvP, and again, if I die, you lose experience. And I don't know, I mean, people just tuning in, like, you know, my guy, what level is he? I'm level 11. But if I died like twice or three times right now, I would go back to level 10. You can actually go back in levels if you die. So there's consequences. It had that kind of risk versus reward. You can die by the hands of a player. Okay, there's a guy right there. Probably way higher level than me. Level 5. Oh, he's level 5. Should I attack this guy? No. Oh, wow, he killed me in one hit. I got killed in one hit. Are you kidding me? That's lame. I lost my studded leather boots. What an asshole. So I'm down to 10%. That sucks. See, I'm just such a low level. Although I think that was someone else that spawned, because that level 5, I don't think I can get one shot by level 5. That doesn't make any sense. I don't even want to go back into Holtberg for that reason, to be honest. Now that sucks. I just lost my boots. So now I'm down to 10%, Vi or whatever it's called. So I'm just gonna get out of town and kill some monsters and get back to normal here. Let's see where I'm at. So I lost a little bit. It's at the lower levels, it's not too bad, but once you get to a higher level, you know, it sucks going back in levels. It doesn't happen a lot, but it's happened to me once or twice. I think I was like level 50. I just hit level 50, then I died, and then I went back to level 49. It just sucks. It sucks when that happens. But yeah, some of the PKs in this game just don't give a rat's ass if you're level 5 or level 11. They'll just kill you just because. They want to make your life hard. So I get it. I'll probably do the same thing when I'm a higher level as well, but I need to get to that point. So again, as I kill monsters, I'm already down to 7%, so I need to get rid of this death penalty real quick. Yeah, it looks like his buddy, his buddy might have teleported in with him or something like that. So, yeah, I had a couple buddies that sold their account, their Darktide account, I think for like $2,000 or like $1,500 or something like that. This was in the heyday of it, obviously. Oh, I got a bow. Oak Warbow. That looks really cool. I'm probably too low level to use it. Oh man, look at that. Bonus to melee defense. That is beautiful. I think I can easily use this. Are you kidding me? Okay, oh my gosh! What the hell? I'm still a noob, though. I need to figure this out. Hey, Tenebris, I guess a question for you as well. A lot of these magic items that I have, a lot of the magic armor... One second. So, like you're saying, each piece of magic armor, obviously, has mana, but each time I use this, the mana goes down, right? So my mana is 426 for this item, 426 out of 567. So when it gets to zero, how do I recharge? How do I recharge this again? I know there's a way to do it. I just forget. There's a way to recharge your. The sound is so loud in my headphones. I don't know if you guys can hear that. The lightning is like so loud I can barely hear myself talk. I don't know if it's quieter on the stream or not, but that is loud. Let me go to ambient sounds real quick. Okay, you can buy mana stones at a mage to refill items. Okay, I knew it. Yeah, that's... It's been so long. I knew there was a way to do it. I just forgot. So that makes sense. So all right, let me just. I want to. So here's my. Okay, my short bow. Is my short bow better than this war bow? I guess that's what I'm trying to figure out here. No, I think the war bow is a little better. Damage bonus 4. Also longer range as well, so yeah, we'll hold on to the warbow. I don't have missile defense yet. I need to get that. Next time I level up, I'm going to get missile defense. I'm going to train it. Your base missile weapon skill is now 107, which is nice. Again, as you use certain items, there's passive abilities that skill up as well. Got a crown here. What do we have? Yeah, arcane lore is 119. I gotta get my arcane lore up a bit as well. I just hate dying. Like, I hate getting one-shotted by these PKs. You know, that's part of, obviously, the full loot PvP. Or not full loot, but it's part of the Darktide server for sure. It's just like, I'm level 11, man. Like, I don't know. You don't have to be a dick, but I've been killed so many times already in this game. It's fine. It's part of it, you know? It's part of it, but it's just like, you know, kind of shitty. One hit kill, that's why you gotta be careful when you go to towns, I guess. Uh-oh. What level are you, buddy? Not too bad. Okay. It just, you know, it just motivates me to level up my character anyways and then own these bastards up anyways that keep killing low levels. You know, there is, like, anti-PKs in this game as well. So there's a lot of PKs, but there are groups of people in this game that are against, you know, the PKs. So you have an interesting dynamic in this server, just based on the rule set. You know, there are PKs that hunt the PKs, basically. But again, if I was like level 80 or level 90, I would be killing everybody. So I get it. I understand how it works. It's all good. This is, I mean, for this game to come out in the year 2000 as well, just how big the game world is for back then is just amazing to think about. And really, you know, there's not a lot of instances. I mean, it's pretty open world. Don't get me wrong. You'll go into a cave, or sometimes you'll go into a portal, but